Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Given the number of people who have been applying for various job positions, you know, there's one sad mistake that I see almost all of them make. One sad mistake. And that one sad mistake, I don't know, you can categorize that as, hope or self-confidence or, you know, a positive mindset. And I'll tell you why I'm saying that, okay? I'll give you an example. Like yesterday, I had this guy. He's from the oil and gas field, okay? He's worked some 20, 25 plus years. He was earning, 40, 50,000, 50 per month. Big salary, okay? Indian guy. You can make out from his resume. He's a typical, like oldie, okay? Big moustache and... like, I call it coffee filter, you know, big mustache and, you know, hair from his ears and, okay, suit and tie, fine. And that basic bullshit CV, fucking long. I think he's written an autobiography of his entire life. Okay, like 6 pages or something. All great achievements. I did this, I did that, I did this, I did that, fine. 6 pages, okay. There's no doubt that he is a very highly experienced guy. Very highly experienced. I have no doubts on his competence. I have no doubt on his experience. I have no questions that he knows his job. Okay? But then the question is, why isn't he getting a job? The normal tendency for people to say is he's not getting a job because market is down. Okay? Market is bad. Fine. Okay, so then, if the market is down, does that mean nobody is getting a job? Does that mean there is no opportunity? Does that mean that, you know, once you lose your job, finished? No, there are opportunities. There are openings. People have to survive. Companies have to grow. You know, the world has to continue. But then the question is, why is this guy not getting his job? So, the normal logic people have is, oh, maybe the salary is too high. Yes, you're right. That also can be a possibility. One is, you know, job opportunities are less. Second one is maybe you're asking a bit too high. So then the question comes, okay, I'm charging a bit too high. Market is bad. So I'll charge low from 50,000, which he was getting. Now they'll ask 40,000. And they'll try. After some time, after another 2-3 months or 6 months, they don't get from 50,000 became 40,000. Every month expense are going. So now they bring it down to 30,000. Okay, they're even ready to work for 50%. Now, if the person by this time should get a job, okay, with a lower salary, yes, most probably they should get a job. But even after this, if they don't get a job, now what exactly is the problem? So there should be something wrong, correct? You can't be without a job for a year or months together or live on a pathetic salary. Okay, if someone's value, which he was getting 50,000, will ask for, let's say, 10,000, easily he'll get a job because that's a benefit for organization, because kind of like a 50,000 dirham value you're getting for 10,000 or whatever, cheap. It'll benefit the company a lot and nobody would say no. But then the question is it sustainable? For a person who is to get 50,000, who increased his lifestyle, his expenses at a 50,000 level, can he come down to 10,000 or 5,000? No. Most probably, it's impossible. Okay? So now the question is, what should the person do? There are only two things. Either one, the person can keep trying and hope he gets lucky. Or the second one is, take outside help. Now keep trying till you get lucky. The only drawback to that is There is, time is not on your hands. As you grow older, you're less desirable. Like, for example, me, I'm 40 now. As I grow older, I'm going to be less attractive, unless, of course, I'm a multi-millionaire or billionaire or whatever. Then I'll be forever attractive. Otherwise, nobody will give a fuck. They'll be like, who's this tattooed, wrinkly, old, ugly-looking fart? Okay. So then it comes down to, okay, take outside help. Now, this is where most, I don't know, people, I wouldn't say just Indians, most people have a problem. The way they approach this is they either go for, when they are buying like fish or buying vegetables, they will go and bargain cheapest and best. Either they'll do that or they'll try to find some way to, how are you? See, this is my landlord's son. Annie, just see, he's coming to give something. No. Annie, come. So what I was saying was, see, either they go like they are fishing for vegetables or getting vegetables or fish or meat, and they try to bargain, or they'll go to google.com. Now, either way, the drawback, I'll tell you what the drawback is. The drawback of google.com is there is so much of information available there. You would not know what to check, what is good, what is not good. Okay, it's like when you get sick nowadays, people just go and check online. They don't go to a doctor anymore. There is plus and there is minus. But where something like personal branding is concerned, or making a customized, see, standard stock resume is easy. You'll get enough and more templates. You just Google search, you'll get enough and more. But customizing it to your needs, to your personality, to your job requirements, to your salary bracket, that you'll not get. You'll get some basic tenets of advice like have a nice photograph or use short, sweet, succinct language. Think what the owner wants. Fine, all that you can do. But the question is, do you know how to do it? There are so many guys, when I speak to them, I tell them your resume is not up to the mark. I give them feedback. At least I do that. Okay, I'll make it okay. And I'll get back to you. Sometimes out of curiosity, I ask them, how will you make it okay? Yeah, I'll check online. I'll do research. Fine. And then they come back to me with some new color, some new layout, some new words. If only it was that easy. See, if it was that easy, I would be without a job. That means everyone can do my job. I mean, just ask yourself, why do people get paid so much money for certain aspects of their job? Why? Why does a marketing guy get paid? Let's say a marketing director, why does he get paid so much of money? Why anybody can't read a book on marketing and become a marketing expert? Why does an engineer at a very senior level get paid so much money? Why can't someone read an engineering book and just do it, or an engineering graduate? There's something called experience. There's something called creativity. There's something called effort, expertise. So people go on and on and on until one fine day, they try, don't succeed. So only two things happen after this. Either they never succeed, they lose everything, or eventually they buckle under pressure and then they come to me, or they'll go to a worthwhile professional. Now, the reason I brought this up is because I see this happening so very often. Now, this coronavirus thing, it's going to take at least 2 to 5 years to normalize. 2 to 5 years. It's not going to happen anytime soon. It's going to take a long time. It's going to completely shake up the landscape, at least for the next few years. If not everything, the fundamentals of how we interact with one another will be impacted forever. And, there'll be a lot of casualties. Casualties in the sense, it's not that just death. Many people are going to lose their businesses. Many people are going to lose their savings, their jobs, their positions of power. It's going to change everything. But I can tell you one thing for a fact. The individuals who, you know, individuals who work intelligently, who are smart, they will continue making money, whether it is taking advantage of the problems by selling masks and, you know, gels and whatever, you know, people who are proactive that way, or people who, you know, approach a professional, rebrand themselves because they're thinking far ahead of time, or people who, you know, even scammers and fraudsters, they are also intelligent people. But those are very few. The categories I gave you, very few. The majority, at least 85-90%, will be the average normal people who will struggle, who will try their luck, and who will hope for themselves to succeed. So I don't wish anyone any bad. Just as I have to make a living, you also have to make a living. So I sincerely hope you succeed, but this virus thing, if countries are not opening their borders, if there's no trade, there's no retail, there's no business, it's a survival of the fittest. And oh, there, either you cut down your salary to maybe half or less than half, or position yourself as someone so amazing that a company would say, yes, I absolutely need your services, because I think maybe through you we can succeed. So you decide what is best for you. And whatever said and done, I wish you all the best. I never wish anyone any bad, because wishing you bad, I don't benefit. Okay, guys? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. This is me signing off. Take care.